Well, welcome back. I hope you all are having fun. We're going to keep things moving along, but one of the things we do is we like to bring back, when we first started this, we had these big name guest speakers like Drew Houston from Dropbox and people like that. Then we realized, why do we do that? Why don't we just bring back people who've been in Delta V and been successful? And that's what we do now. And so, Mike? Okay. And so, just an interesting statistics is when I talk to people, I say, what percent of entrepreneurs succeed? You know, what do you think? And they say, oh, maybe 10%, maybe 1%. Well, the data for MIT shows that 60% of the entrepreneurs are still in business 5 years later. And then what we did is we did a study and we found out that 75% of those companies that from Delta V were still in business 5 years later, which is amazing. And then even more interesting was the companies with female CEOs, 90% of those were still in business. So guys, you gotta pick up your game. All right, so next up is a company we're extremely proud of. They were in the 2017 Delta V cohort. They were very passionate about what they did, which was urban health. And they're gonna tell you about that, and they focused on a scourge on society that's very important to Governor Baker, who was just here, and they're going to tell you that story. It's the opioid crisis. So it's my great pleasure to welcome Newsha and Mariana from Biobot Analytics.
Thank you, Bill, for that introduction. We're so happy to be here. I am Mariana Mattes.
And I'm Newsha Ghaeli. And we are the founders of Biobot Analytics. In 2017, as Bill mentioned, we were sitting right over there. Woo!
And what we do is at Biobot, we measure the concentration of opioids in wastewater to estimate drug consumption in cities. This is a big problem and the first product that we have built. And this type of approach is called wastewater-based epidemiology.
And wastewater epidemiology is based on a pretty simple concept. Everybody pees every day. And we already know that urine contains a rich source of information on our health and well-being. Our doctors look at it all the time. And all of this information we're parting with on a daily basis. We're flushing it down the toilet, and it's collecting in our city sewers. At Biobot, we're the first company in the world that's commercializing public health data from sewage.
And how does this work? Well, based on research that we did at MIT, we have built a technology platform. It has a sampling device that is installed in sewer manholes. There is a chemical lab analysis to measure the concentration of different opioids, and computational pipelines to analyze and visualize our data into actionable reports for our customers. And our vision is that one day, this smart wastewater infrastructure will exist everywhere in the world. And the technology will get better. You know, beyond looking at opioids, we will be looking at a large variety of public health data to make an impact. Even today, tackling the opioid epidemic with our first product has a lot of opportunity. Every day, 130 people die of an opioid overdose in this country. And the problem has been getting worse despite billions of dollars of investments on the side of the government.
And our product can really make a difference. Our first customer decreased overdoses by 40% in the first year that we worked with them. We partnered with the town of Cary in North Carolina to run a pilot last year. And armed with our data, city officials were able to launch more targeted and tailored public health interventions and messaging. Town officials held over 50 town hall-style meetings where they were able to talk to the community about the types of drugs that were most commonly found and the relevant interventions that were available to them. The city also saw a threefold increase in the interventions that they had deployed in that same year. They have now converted to a full customer.
So imagine this. 2 years ago, we were pitching in this stage for the Delta V demo day. Last year, we launched with our first customer in North Carolina. And today, we're happy to announce we are deployed across 7 municipalities.
Now, it wasn't so easy getting to 7. Actually, oftentimes, it felt a lot like this.
Now, we're going to walk you through a brief history of what we have done over the past 2 years, and then we will share 4 things we have learned along the way. 4 things to share with this year's Delta V class, as well as all aspiring entrepreneurs in this audience.
So Biobot started as an MIT research project. Mariana started the work as part of her PhD and got a grant which allowed me and several other researchers to join the work. This is a photo of our research team actually back in 2015. 5 of the people on this team are on the current Biobot team today. Together, we got to travel the world. We sampled in Kuwait, and I don't recommend wearing plastic lab coats in the Middle Eastern summer. We got to go to South Korea, and along this journey of lugging sewage across continents, Mariana and I got to talking, and we realized that, you know what, there might actually be a company here in what we're building. So just like many of the people in this room, we started to apply to all of the MIT entrepreneurship competitions. We got support and funding from Sandbox, from Ideas Global Challenge, from DesignX, and then finally landed a coveted spot in the Delta V Accelerator. This is our fire team from that summer.
With Delta V under our belt, we packed our bags and moved to San Francisco in early 2018 to join the Y Combinator batch. During that time, we were also very fortunate to win the South by Southwest Civic Pitch Competition, which was judged by over 30 US mayors. And this experience culminated with our YC Demo Day pitch, as well as raising our first round of venture funding. And with that money, we didn't stay in California. We packed again, and we moved to the Boston area because because we pretty much agree with Governor Baker that the community that we have here is amazing, and MIT has been so influential in our journey that we wanted to stay close to this community. As we came back, our first employee and also MIT alum, Noriko Endo, was preparing to launch our first pilot in North Carolina. And also, somewhere around then, I found the time to defend my PhD thesis.
No big deal. As we got started, we got a lot of press coverage. As you can imagine, an all-female team working with sewage and poop. It was pretty interesting for some folks. But by far, our favorite headline was just earlier this year, we made the Forbes list of the 50 top women-led startups that are crushing tech.
All right. So now let's get into it. The first lesson that we want to share is entrepreneurship has many starting points. Maybe some of you already know that you want to start a company when you're joining MIT. But we didn't. Newsha is an architect, I am a computational biologist, and we came to MIT to do research. And it was really along the way that we found our passion in wastewater and cities and data and public health, and we became entrepreneurs. But there's no formal education for that. The best you can learn is to be open to unexpected opportunities and to pick up the skills that you need along the way. In fact, it's very comforting to realize that when you're building a startup, you're building a new product. There's no playbook for what you are building or for what you are selling. So be very open with being uncomfortable and learning along the way.
Now, when you think of startup founders, what do you think? I bet it's something like this. And it's not your fault. That's how it's portrayed in the media. We see a lot of pictures like this, a bunch of dudes in a basement writing code. But entrepreneurs come in many different shapes and sizes. And we've seen this firsthand over our last 2 years, both in California and here. Our work touches on some pretty old school industries, some industries that also happen to be fairly male dominated: hardware, infrastructure, government. But we're also a tech company, and we're also a biotech company. So what does that look like? Well, that looks like this. So be comfortable. Be comfortable being different and lean into those differences, because oftentimes that's exactly what's going to make you the most successful.
Also, try to launch quick and iterate. This is how we used to sample wastewater when we just got started. We needed all of that equipment, lots of people, closing off streets, and you know, our footprint was massive, as you could see here. But since then, we have built over 30 different sampling prototypes. You can see here three of the main generations to make it as easy and seamless to use as, you know, just dropping it inside the manhole. And one very important thing during this process was to deploy those samplers in the wastewater as soon as possible, because things will be different from what you were doing in the lab, and, you know, things will break. In fact, this photo was taken just 3 days ago in North Carolina, and without much detail, let's just say that the sampling device got into a little adventure in the sewers over there.
And a very dedicated public works employee that picked up all the pieces and laid it out for us. And finally, be kind. Be kind to Bill Ouellette. But wait, I prefer this picture. Have you guys heard that Bill used to play basketball? Well, now we have it here in real life. No, but in all seriousness, Bill, the entire Trust Center staff, as well as the broader MIT entrepreneurship community, have been integral and so supportive for us every step of the way. And as Mariana mentioned, was the reason why we moved back and headquartered here in Massachusetts. Moreover, Delta V class, look to your left and to your right. The people that you're sitting next to, these are going to be your peers along this path as entrepreneurs. So be kind to one another. Lean on each other, support each other. It can get extremely lonely as a founder, and you are each other's best resources.
So let's revisit that image. And you know, while you may be in a roller coaster and the ride may be crazy, it actually can be fun. So be mindful, celebrate the people around you, choose the right team. Your co-founder is going to become as close as, you know, your life partner is, and it's going to be actually fun, not scary. So class of Delta V 2019, we are very excited for you, for all of the great things that you will continue to accomplish, and just hold on and enjoy the ride.